Yes, if you just observe this word dehydrohalogenation, you can easily know that D stands for removal. D stands for removal. Removal of hydrogen and halogen reactions. We call it as dehydrohalogenation reactions. So let's take an example for this. We have this chloroethane, also known as ethyl chloride. When this an alloalkane, it is reacted with alcoholic KOH, that means any base, it forms the product of. So before writing the product, you need to understand a concept of alpha carbon atom and beta carbon atom. This carbon we call it as alpha carbon, and this carbon we call it as beta carbon. It is alpha carbon atom is the carbon atom which is attached to the functional group. Here in this case, in this ethyl chloride, chlorine is the functional group, that is a halogen, you know that. So this is the carbon which is attached to this functional group. So we call it as alpha carbon atom. And the carbon atom which is next to that of the alpha carbon atom, we call it as beta carbon atom. So in this case of dehydrohalogenation reactions are what we generally call it as eliminations reaction. Here in this case, the halogen will be removed from the alpha carbon atom and hydrogen will be eliminated from the beta carbon atom, and there will be the formation of alkenes. Okay, so for example, we have CH2 plus KCl plus KCl and water will be eliminated. Clear? So in this, hydrogen have been eliminated from the beta carbon, and here chlorine have been eliminated from the alpha carbon atom. Clear? So thus it results in the formation of an alkene. We have a double bond over here, so it is an alkene. This is ethene with the formation of potassium chloride, a salt and water. Okay, these type of reactions where an halogen is eliminated from alpha carbon and hydrogen is eliminated from beta carbon and results in the formation of an alkenes, we call it as elimination reactions. Clear, students? So for this reason it is also known as dehydrohalogenation, because D, it is the removal. We have hydrogen removed from beta carbon and halogen, it is removed from the alpha carbon atom. So this is regarding dehydrohalogenation reactions, and we have one more rule regarding this elimination reaction, that is Zaitsev rule. We have 5 carbon atom, pentene, 2 bromo pentene. We have 2 bromo pentene over here. Okay, so when it is reacted with alcoholic KOH, I don't have space, let me write it here. Halogen should be removed include either of these two carbon atoms. So let us see what is the most preferred product. So the major product would be this one. We have CH3, CH2, CH double bond, CH, CH2H. This is one product. See, we have the halogen removed here and hydrogen have been removed here. And we have one more product, that it is CH3, CH2, CH2, CH, CH2. Here's what. So here also the same thing. This is pentoene. This is pentoene. And this is pen-1-in, clear? Pen-1-in, okay? According to this, there is a rule, this will be the major product of 81% and this will be the minor product, it is just 19%, okay? Got it? So this is, see, in this case, the same thing is alpha carbon atom. Halogen has to be removed. In the both the cases also, in case of alpha carbon atom, halogen has been removed. And we have two beta carbon over here. Okay, so can. In the first case, in the major product, the hydrogen have been removed from this beta carbon. And that is the major product. That is pentoene. We have 5 carbon atoms, so it is pent. And we have a double bond, so it is ene. And the double bond is for the second carbon. If you go on numbering this, the second, the double bond is in second carbon atom. It is pent 2 in. In this case, the double bond is in the first carbon atom. It is pent 1 in. So why? What is the reason why this is the major product? Why it is not? Because it follows it. So according to this, the product will be. In this product, the double bonded carbon atoms should have more alkyl group. Okay, whereas in this case, this is minor. It is because the double bonded carbon atom will not be having more alkyl group. Whereas if you observe this, this is the double bonded carbon atom, and this is having more alkyl group. So because of this, generally in the hydroalkylation group, so this follows the major product will be pent 2. That the double bonded carbon atom should have the more alkyl. This is regarding the Zaitsev rule. So we have the next one is organometallic compounds.
Not reagent. It's just
general formula is RMGX. Don't forget, this is a very important one. Grignard reagents. RMGX is the general formula of Grignard reagent, where R is any alkyl group and Mg is magnesium. Magnesium and X is, you know, it is an halogen. Okay, so if you just put an ethyl group, Mg and bromine, this is a Grignard reagent. Yeah, so its name is ethyl magnesium bromide. Okay, these organometallic compounds are helpful for mainly synthesis of many chemicals. Okay, this is organometallic compounds. Let us see how would we prepare this Grignard reagent. Let us look at the preparation of this Grignard reagent. Preparation is very important, students. When an alkyl halide, that is RX, it is treated with magnesium in the presence of dry ether, you will get RMGX, that is Grignard reagent. Okay, so alkyl halide can take anything. For example, you have a simple alkyl halide, methyl chloride. When it is heated with magnesium, the symbol is for heating, in the presence of dry ether, you will get methyl magnesium chloride, that is a Grignard reagent. Okay, we have the reactions of this Grignard reagents. Very, very important reaction. Wood's reaction, the reaction of alkyl halide with sodium. Okay, we have an alkyl halide. When it is treated with sodium in the presence of dry ether acts as a catalyst here, we get higher alkane with sodium halide. Okay, so this is a Wood's reaction, very important reaction, that is when an alkyl halide reacts with sodium metal in the presence of dry ether, it forms respective alkanes. Okay, so this reaction we call it as a Wood's reaction. It is very, very simple. We are taking two molecules of an alkyl halide, be careful. So let's take the example of the simple alkyl halide, the methyl chloride. When it is treated with sodium in the presence of dry ether, it forms, you have 2CH3 here, don't forget. So you get 3Cl plus 2NaCl. That's the salt sodium chloride, and we have, this is an alkyl halide, methyl chloride or chloromethane. Methyl chloride is the common name and chloromethane is the IUPAC name. When it is treated with a sodium metal in the presence of dry ether, forms an alkane. This is an ethane. Okay, students. So this is Wood's reaction, very important reaction for the point of your board examination. And you'll be having one more reaction called Wood's Wittig reaction that you'll study in the next classes. So So don't forget this, what's the reaction? So this is regarding organic metallic compounds. Now we have a question regarding the reactivity of aryl halides towards the nucleophilic substitution reaction. So we have studied the nucleophilic substitution reaction, that is SN1 and SN2 reactions. There, if you observe that we have not used the halohalides, that means we have not used the aromatic group of halogens, we have only used haloalkanes. So the question is, why haloalkanes are less reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reactions? Okay, an important one. Why haloalkanes are less reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reaction? Very important question for the mind of your board examination. Okay, the first reason for this is due to the resonance effect. The resonance effect. Regarding resonance, you studied in your first PhD classes. See, the basic difference between haloalkane and haloalanes is this is the arrangement of an haloalanes. Clear? An aromatic ring, in which the halogen is attached, that is an haloalanes. Whereas haloalkane is very simple. Haloalkanes, we have this, an alkyl group is attached to an halogen group. See, in this case, due to the resonance effect, this bond, the bond between the carbon atom and that of the halogen behaves as a double bond. Okay, due to the resonance effect, the CX bond behaves as a double bond. So if it is a double bond, behaves as a double bond, and it is stronger. Clear? So because of this reason, as the bond between the carbon in the aromatic ring and that of the X, that is halogen, is stronger, as it behaves as a double bond due to the resonance effect, it is more stronger bond. It is having more stronger bond, so it is very hard to break that bond. Okay. So for example, if you want to have a chemical reaction, any nucleophilic substitution reaction, means the bond has to be broken. And nucleophile has to substitute that bond. That's the thing in nucleophilic substitution reaction. So whereas in this case, in the case of haloalanes, there is a double bond between the carbon and the halogen group. It behaves as a double bond, so it is more stronger, and it is very hard to break that double bond. Because of that reason, this haloalanes does not show nucleophilic substitution reaction. It is hard to break. It is hard to substitute that halogen with a nucleophile. This is the first reason. And second one is sp2 hybridized carbon atom in haloalkanes. See, in case of haloalkanes, in haloalkanes, carbon is sp3 hybridized. So s has only 25% carbon. Okay, so sp3, you know how to calculate the percentage characteristic of s and sp3. Know that it is sp3, you have totally 4 bonds. S is 1 and p is 3. So 1 divided by 4, 1 plus 3 into 100. Okay, so you get like 25% of S character in sp3. You have calculated it in first PUC, right? So this is in case of haloalkanes, whereas in haloalanes, In this case, the S has 33.3% character. That carbon has 33% S character. Okay. So why it is? Because this is an halogen. This is the carbon that we are talking about. Okay. This carbon is having a double bond. So know that if there is a double bond for carbon, it is sp2 hybridized. In that case, S character is 33%. Because of this higher percentage of S character, the bond in sp2 hybridized carbon atom, that means in halogens, the bond is very strong. The bond is very strong due to 33% S character in sp2 hybridized. Okay, as the bond is strong, it is very hard to break the bond. So the nucleophilic substitution reaction is not so much possible in halogens. Clear students? These are the two reasons why halogens are less reactive towards nucleophilic substitution on SLN due to the resonance effect. That CX bond behaves as a double bond, so it is very strong. And due to the sp2 hybridized carbon atom in halogens, in that case, sp2 hybridized means the S character will be more, so the bond strength will be more. If the bond strength is more, you cannot break, so you cannot substitute that halogen with that of the nucleophile. Okay, these are the two reasons for the less reactivity of halogens for nucleophilic substitution reaction. Thank you.